Hello, I'm Todd Haynes, and I'm going to be answering all of your burning questions about the ending of May, December.
Class of 2015, go Sharks!
This scene is a face-off. This is a coda for the film that comes before the final coda of the film. And in the script, described that the two women would be in white against the red gowns on the green of the football field. So a sense of these strong primary colors and how much the two women would be singled out in their clothes. But really, it's this face-off of power between the two women that follows what we just witnessed, which was Elizabeth sleeping with Joe.
Disgusting. I don't know what he's doing telling you these things.
He told you?
Georgie, the son from the first marriage, who drops this hint about the origins of Gracie's transgressions with Joe coming out of incest.
Her older brothers?
What?
Yeah. Started when she was 12.
It's a late-breaking bit of insight into how we understand Gracie that Elizabeth can add to her collection of knowledge, experience, intelligence, gathering. But here, even that is retreated, marked by Gracie as something she's aware of and that she's absolutely on top of.
Insecure people are very dangerous, aren't they? I'm secure.
I'm naive, I always have been, which is what she says. In many ways, it's been a gift. These examples that show how resolute the unself-examining person is and how much strength is derived accordingly. And when one thinks that the searching for truth suggests a sort of access to power, because you're going through the deceptions and tearing them down, this scene suggests that it's the reverse.
Make sure you put that in there.
It's the denial that occupies a position of greater power. And in the very last moments that you're left with Elizabeth, you sort of see that quiver of uncertainty. These women are predators. These women succeed in achieving what they need at any cost. And so we're left to question what those costs are. Now, all of that said, the very fact that somebody is seeking the truth and trying to tell a story about somebody else and putting the sort of goal of representation first and foremost, this is what gives Joe the possibility in his life for the first time to look at himself.
What if I wasn't ready to be making those kinds of decisions?
And so he does look into the mirror.
Joshua Wyatt Atkins.
We feel like the only character who is maybe capable of change is Joe. And none of that would have happened without this process.
Action.
Are you scared?
No.
It's okay to be scared.
I'm not.
She doesn't bite.
That final scene was part of Sammy's original script. The repetition is very important. That search for truth is impossible and unending. And the desire for the product is really ineffable in a way and somewhat absurd. This being the final product of what Elizabeth has been trying to do as an artist. But it kind of looks like that TV movie. It also repeats in a funny way all of these additions, these multiples of Joes in the film, that sort of parade of versions of truth. Who's the real Joe? Where does he live? Which is the right Joe? Which is the actual origin of Joe? All of these are also sort of circulating in this scene. So you're left with ambiguous and conflicted feelings about all kinds of behavior. And yet it's also what makes the film ultimately Joe's story.
Beautiful, I think we got it.
Can we do it again, please? Please, just for me.
Lizzie.
Please, it's getting more real.
Going again?
Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the ending of May, December.